Hello everyone, welcome to this video. Today we're going to be discussing expectation values in quantum mechanics. So the last few times we discussed the Schrödinger equation, its interpretation, and the normalization of wave functions. Now we can finally begin to talk about some of the more useful things, basically how to actually use this wave function once we know it. So let's start by remembering some things about statistics. Usually, when we want to know the expectation value of some quantity, let's say we want to know the expectation value of some position, we usually write this in these brackety symbols here. And this, well, it depends if this is not a continuous variable, you can just write it out as a sum, as the possible values of this variable times the probability of this value. Overall of its, the sum is over all of its possible values. So this is usually how you can find it in some discrete case. And when you go to the continuum case, this is just going to be the integral of the same things. This can be as a function of x, dx. So this is how it's done in normal mechanics, statistics. I hope you have seen this before. If not, I would advise you to go and check some basic video about it. It's not too complicated, but it is good if you have already seen it before. So now we want to begin talking about these expectation values, but in quantum mechanics, because in quantum mechanics, as we have discussed, we need to think in terms of probabilities. So we can't exactly know what the outcome of some experiment is going to be, but it is good to know what can be expected. So the expectation value is going to tell us if we, it's basically an average. If you do many times some experiment, it's going to tell you what is this basic average result that you can get. So how can we find this? If we take a look at this formula right here, now there is a better proof of the formula that we will get, but it does require some more knowledge of the mathematical methods of quantum mechanics. It works with the completeness of the Hilbert spaces. So I think it's better to, for now, just go with this demonstration that is not all that in-depth. We will maybe talk about the other one in the future, when we have seen more about the bracket notation and talked about Hilbert spaces in more detail. So as I was saying, we can see this formula for this just classical statistical expectation value. But remember that in quantum mechanics, this probability is just psi squared. So in quantum mechanics, let's write it down, in quantum mechanics, we would have this expectation value of x. This is just going to be the integral over all possible x's, so from minus infinity to infinity, of our variable times this. Oh, I just noticed I called this n and this I. They should have been the same. Sorry about that, and this shouldn't be there. Okay, so and this time our probability is just going to be this psi squared, which we know we can write as psi conjugate psi dx. And since all of these are scalars and x is just a variable, we can write this in this more suggestive form, in which we take this x here in the middle, dx. Okay, this is an extremely important result. Now, the next thing that we want to do is to find the expectation value for the momentum. And we will see that it has the same form as this. Now, once again, there is a much more thorough proof that if you're interested, just let me know and I can make a video on it, because it is a little bit longer. I don't like to make my videos too long, so I can make a separate video about it if there is interest. But in general, as we can see, the form for an expectation value, in this case of the momentum, this is going to be, once again, integrating from minus infinity to infinity. But in this case, it's going to be, this is psi conjugate, and the momentum operator will go here in the middle of these psi wave functions. So the important thing to notice is that the operator will always go in between of these two psi wave functions. So if we have some random expectation value of some function q or operator q, what this is going to be, this is just going to be the integral as before of psi conjugate, and here in the middle is going to be this q of x psi dx. Okay, this is what you need to know. So if you have an operator and you want to know what is the expectation value, then this is going to be what tells you this expectation value. We're going to be doing a lot of calculations. I will do a few examples on this topic because it's very important, and we will be continuing to come back to use this. So I cannot stress enough how important it is that you know and understand these formulas. They all come from this fact from statistics that the expectation value is just this sum of probabilities times the value of each probability. So that is it for this time. We still have to take a look at the uncertainty principle, but after that we can finally begin doing some actual things. So I'll see you then.